स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम बैक इन अवर बायोलॉजी सेशन एंड वेरी वॉर्म गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग अवर लेसन दैट इज ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इन प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स। सो फ्रॉम दिस लेसन अप टिल नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द मेन पॉइंट्स। वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम, वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द सर्कुलेटरी ऑर्गन्स। ओके, सो दिस वर्ड वी आर यूजिंग कंटिन्यूअसली। बट हैव यू नो हु डिस्कवर्ड दिस कंसेप्ट? So there was a great scientist and the name of that scientist was William Harvey. So he discovered the process or the term circulation, or we can say he discovered the circulation of the blood. So William Harvey was the English physician who discovered the circulation of the blood. So his opinion was the blood is flowing through the vessels. But that time many people didn't accept his view and called them to start it as a circulator. Okay, and because of his statement, he has lost so many patients. But at the end, before he died, the Harvey's idea was accepted by biological fact. Okay, so now the important thing or the key sentence you have to keep in the mind is that the circulation of the blood is discovered by the English physician William Harvey. So up till now we have discussed about the circulation in the human being. But have you think there are the certain organisms like that we can say that hydra is there or the sponge is there? How they are doing the circulation? Whether they are also having the blood? No, so this hydra and the sponge doesn't have any type of the blood. So how they can circulate all these different things? So these organisms can circulate these circulated different things along with their water or along with their area where they are living. So basically these animals are living in the water. So with the help of the water, they are taking inside the water, with the help of that water they are taking inside oxygen and the food. And also water helps to throw out the waste material and the carbon dioxide from their body. So this organism doesn't require the any type of the special fluid for the transportation of the different substances in the body. With the help of the water, all the process of the transpiration is going on well. So up till now we have discussed about all these about the circulatory system. Now we will see the next point from the same lesson, that is what? Excretion in animals. Okay, so in our previous lesson we have discussed about that respiration. What we have discussed in that we are doing the respiration means what? We are taking the oxygen. Oxygen is get utilized to break down the food, and that food we are using to get the energy. Okay, or that breakdown of the food produces the energy that we are using. So in this way, while breakdown of the food, energy also released, and one type of the waste product is also getting produced. Okay, but that waste product is nothing but what? Carbon dioxide. And how we are throwing out that carbon dioxide? With the help of our lungs. So we can say that as in our digestive system is there, which help us to throw out our undigested food. But these are the only two waste products that our body is prepared? No. Answer is what? No. There are some other products are also there which are getting prepared, or these are the certain substances which are get prepared in our body. So how our body is throwing out all these different substances? So let's come to know, or let's find out the answer for this same question. There are different waste material produced in our body, but which are that different types of the exactly food materials are or the waste materials are? So as we know, human body is made up of cell. So when the cell is performing their activities or their functions, with the help of that, or when they are performing the activities and functions, they release a certain amount of the waste materials in the form of sweat, urine. Okay, and it is very important to throw out this waste material from our body. So the process of removal of waste products in the cells of the living organisms is called excretion. So the throwing out of the waste products which are prepared or which are formed due to the different functions of the cell, and that process is called as what? Excretion. Again I will repeat, the process of removal of waste products in the cells of the living organism is called excretion. That process is called as what? Excretion. So there are the different parts involved in that excretion process, and that parts are called as what? Excretory parts, and that system or that process is called as what? Excretory system. Okay, so we can say that the part involved in the excretion forms the excretory system, or we can say that the organs which are taking part in the process of excretion, that organs forms one system And what is the name of that system? That is what? Excretory system. So which are the excretory organs? So the excretory organs are kidney, ureter, urinary bladder and urethra. All these are the excretory organs. Along with that, we can say the lungs also helps to throw out the carbon dioxide, and our skin also helps to throw out the sweat. Okay. But if we talk about excretory system, then which are the excretory organs? Kidney, ureter, urinary bladder and urethra. Okay. So let's discuss about the human excretory system. So as we know, so many waste products are getting formed, but it is necessary to throw out that waste material from our body. And who perform that work, or who is the main leader in that activity? That is nothing but what? Kidney. So kidney helps to throw out the waste materials from our body. So there are the two kidneys are present in the human body. These kidneys are situated at the level of the waist on the either sides of the vertebral column. On the both the sides of the vertebral column, on the level of the waist, there are these two kidneys situated. Okay. So these kidneys are containing the so many nephrons. Now you can see what is mean by exactly nephrons. So the kidneys are the brick red and the bean shape. Okay, the what is the color of the kidney? Brick red, and what is their shape? Bean shape. Okay. So this kidney contains a large number of coiled tubes, and that coiled tubes are called as what? Nephrons. So you can see in the image how exactly nephrons. Okay. So this kidney contains a large number of coiled tubes, which is called as nephrons, and these nephrons are acts like a filter. So when the blood comes into the kidneys, that blood contains both the type of the substances, means it contains the useful substance also and the harmful substances also. So the useful substances get absorbed back into the blood. Okay, the useful substances get absorbed back into the blood, and nephrons helps to remove all the harmful materials from the blood. Which are the harmful material? We can say that what? Urea is there, the waste salt is there, and etc. Like that, harmful substances are getting or are get filtered with the help of the nephrons. So with the help of the nephrons, as you know, this nephron is act like a filter. So with the help of the nephron, the kidney filters the harmful substances or throw out the harmful substances. Which are the harmful substances? We can say that what? Urea and the waste salt from the blood. Okay, from the blood. After that, these waste substances which are get purified by the nephrons, all these waste substances are get dissolved into the water and throwing out from the body, or throwing out these all the waste material get dissolved into the water and throwing out from our body as a yellowish substance, which is called as what? Urine. Okay, which is called as what? Urine. So let's see how exactly we are throwing out the urine. So urine get prepared into the kidney, it get transferred to the urinary bladder with the help of the ureter. Okay, so from the both the side of the ureter, the urine get transferred to the urinary bladder. Okay, so these ureters are nothing but the tube like structures. Okay, these ureters are nothing but the tube like structure which helps to transport the urine from kidney to the urinary bladder. So in the urinary bladder, the urine get collected, and we are throwing out that urine at the regular interval of the time through the opening present at the end of the urinary bladder, which is called as what? Urethra. Okay, so with the help of that urethra, we are throwing out the urine outside from our body. Regular interval, we are throwing out the urine through this urinary opening which is present in our body, and that urinary opening we can call as what? Urethra. Okay, so here we can say that what? Kidney, ureter, urinary bladder and urethra. All these are the four organs of your excretory system. Okay. So normally an adult human being within a 24 hours releases the 1 to 1.8 liters of urine. And what does that urine contain? So the urine contains 95% water, 2.5% urea, 2.5% other waste. Okay. So all these are the mixture which contains the urine, and that we are throwing out through the urinary opening which is present in the excretory system, which is called as what? Urethra. Okay. So this is all about what? Excretory system. But so have you seen that whenever there is a summer season, then they are sweating a lot, okay? And sometimes we can say the yellow color patches present on the some areas of our body, especially we can say that in the underarms. So why is it so? Because that sweat is also contained in different types of the salts and the minerals, which remain certain patches on the clothes. Okay, so have you anything? Why we are sweating? There is any purpose behind that? Yes, obviously there is one reason behind that, because that sweating keeps our body cool. Okay, it helps to maintain our normal body temperature. This function is the same as we are keeping the water in the earthen pots, or we are telling as a matka. So in that matka, the waters becomes cool. Why? Because from that small holes which are present on that earthen pots, the waters get evaporate, which keeps the inside water cool. Like the same functions of the sweat is performed in our body, which helps to maintain the normal body temperature and cools our body. So, as a human being is doing the excretion in the form of urine, there are some other animals are also, those who are also showing this excretory product, they are also showing the, they are also throwing out this excretory products, but in a different form. And these excretory products are depends on the availability of the water, means how much availability of the water is there. According to that, the animals are throwing out the excretory products. Okay, for example, if we talk about the camel, then this camel urine is so much concentrated. Why is it so? Because as we know, the camel is living in a desert region and there is extremely scarcity of the water. Camel is not getting enough water to drink, and if he will lose the whole water in the form of urine, then it is not good idea for the, or it is not good for the camel. And that is the reason very less amount of the water is present in the camel's urine. That is the reason it is so much concentrated. If we talk about the fish, so as we know, the fish is living in the water. So this fish is living in the water and throwing out their cell waste in the form of ammonia, which get directly mixed into the water. Also, we can say that there are the certain animals like birds, lizard is there, snakes is there. Okay, so all these are certain animals are there, those who are also throwing out their waste materials as a semi-solid white color substance. So that semi-solid white color substance is nothing but what? Uric acid. Okay, but the major amount of the waste product secreted or the throwing out by the human body is nothing but what? Urea. So we are throwing out the waste products from our body in the form of urea, or whatever we are throwing out the urine from our body, it contains the whole amount of the urea. Okay, so in this way, now we have discussed about the excretory system of human being. But in some cases, what happens is some people, this kidney stops their work or they cannot perform their functions properly. So it means what? The kidney is unable to purify the blood. So this process of the purification of the blood is done by some instruments, and that process is called as what? Dialysis. Okay, so for the purification of the blood, or the purification of the blood is done with the help of some instrument, and that process is called as what? Dialysis, which is a very painful process. Okay, so that is the reason we have to drink a plenty of the water within a day, which helps to maintain our kidneys healthy. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the human excretory system. So today we will stop here. We'll meet in the next video, and for today, thank you.